So good afternoon to all. Today we are going to have a look on the hardware experiment of PLC. Okay, we are going to perform different operations, arithmetic operations like AND gate, OR gate, and timer, counter, on delay timer. After that, down counter, up counter, and latching of the motor. So before starting to this hardware, we have already seen in virtual lab in our first experiment and second and even third, we have seen the different latching and different conventional gates operation. Okay, in COP virtual lab experimentation, you can refer to that also. But today we are going to interface our computer system software RX Logic X into the PLC. Okay, so I will show you the setup for this. So to set up that, we have first of all we have to go to the settings and we have to change our Ethernet properties. Okay, and we have to change it according to the PLC. So IP address I have chosen 192.168.1 and for 20, and again default gateway we are going to choose 192.168.1.1. okay, we have to save all the things, and after this is the IP address of the PC and the different IP address of PLC we have to set up in the boot this application, boot p desktop. Okay, so open this pdsc. Okay, so that in that boot p only boot p application we just need to set up the IP address, that is of the PLC 192.168.1.60. okay, so no need to show that. For before that we are going to have a look on the application which is used for the interfacing of PLC with your software. So for that purpose we need to go to this RX Linux Classic. So we have to go to communication, then configure our drivers. For that we have to use Ethernet driver. Okay, as Ethernet connection is given to that of that PLC. Now go to Windows default, we can see here. Okay, then apply it. So go to communication, go to RSU, you can see here Ethernet. Okay, this 192.168.1.60 is your MicroLogix 1400 PLC hardware. Okay, this is interconnected with the Ethernet port with your PC. So minimize this application and then we have to go to the ladder diagram. For that we have to go to this RX Logic application. Okay, after confirming the interconnection, so we have to choose this series A, then okay, this is your ladder diagram interface. Okay, here you can easily, first of all you have to create a rung by using this rung icon. Okay, so now take a NO contact, two NO contact, this is for AND operation. Okay, so now you can double click on it and you can have to put the address of the hardware. So in case of hardware there are 19 inputs, so each input there are two push buttons and different switches as inputs. Okay, for toggling that we have to turn it on, and each input button has its own memory address. Okay, so how to put memory address I will show here. So I:O/1. okay, this is for the I1 push button. Okay, switch button, switch or push button. So whenever I1 switch is turned on, this will glow in green. Okay, so now for the second input I:0/2, okay, I2, and output we have to specify to indicate the output. Output is indication in terms of LED light, okay, red LED. I will show you after the end of this video. Now, okay, output is 0/1. So first LED. So now we have to verify the project. After verifying, you can see here there are no errors found. Okay. Now we have to download this project into the PLC. For that purpose, we have to go to this comms, and then we have to download it. We have to click it here. You can see here our PLC, download it. Again, you can take the put the name of your ladder diagram, whatever name you want. You have to select a folder, you can put the name. Okay, then you have to save that diagram or the PLC program. You can create a folder for that. Name of folders can be your name also, or whatever you can remember easily. You can save, you can yes. Okay, then yes, you can go to the online run mode, then online. Okay, so after being online, this will turn, okay, into green, and this will rotate. Okay, this is the GIF file of the ladder diagram. It will rotate. Okay, you can see here. Okay, now this has been turned, okay, turned on. So now after pressing the buttons, this is turned on. By pressing 1, this is turned. By pressing 2, this is turned on. And for the operation of AND, both the inputs should be 1. So as both the inputs are 1, output is also 1. This is for AND operation. So for different operations like OR, okay, for OR you have to create another rung. You can see here for OR operation, click on this to create a rung. Okay, click on this rung. Rung is created. You can take a contact. Okay, then you have to use this parallel rung branch. So for OR gate, you have to add the inputs. Okay, so if any input is 1 or high, the output will be high. For both, if both the inputs are 0, output is 0, and if both the inputs are 1, output is also 1. So now choose this one, okay, rung branch, then you have to make it parallel connection. So just drag it here, and then again you can click it here, and you can add one normally open contact. Okay, so then you can take an output. You just need to specify the inputs, okay, port. So now as we have given this as 1, this as 2, okay, we cannot, if we give the same input address to this 2 as given here, this both will also turn on, there will be overlap. So for that purpose, we have 19 different inputs. We can give different inputs for different switches. So they have given third input here and fourth here. Okay, you can see here I:0/4. So if you press the fourth switch, this will turn on, and output will be given as I:0/1. This is for 1, this is for 2. Then again you have to verify the project. It will show error, no errors found. Okay, after modification in the ladder diagram, you have to verify that. And again, you have to go download the project or the ladder diagram. You have to run this. You have to go to the run mode, and you have got go to online. Okay, you can see here. So after pressing the third switch and fourth switch, this will turn on. Okay, third switch is turned on, this is on, this is also on. okay, because of OR operation plus addition operation. Okay, if both are 0, this is 0. Both are on, this is on. If anyone is on, this is also on. Both are 0, this is 0. Okay, this is for the OR operation. Next one, we are going to have a look on okay, on timer. So for that we have already seen the on timer in the CVP lab, virtual lab, practical. Okay, just take a normally open contact, give the address, okay, and then use T on timer delay. Go to timer and counter here, then go to T on, then click, okay, it will automatically click here and put the name of the timer. You can put whatever you want, T on, T off, or T for that one. Okay, you can then go to the preset. You can choose the preset value. So preset value is nothing but the value in seconds after which your timer will turn on. So in case of virtual lab, we have seen the preset timer in milliseconds. So here it is in seconds. Okay. So I have given preset value as 5. And now if you want to check the, there are two bits. First one is enable bit, second one is done bit. Okay. So if you want to check this done bit, indication of done bit, you can add it here. Okay. So just for that purpose, use a examine if closed contact. Okay. Just put the name slash DN bit. Okay. To indicate the DN done bit and use an output. Okay, then you can specify the output here. After that you can go to the verify project comms, then download the project to the PLC. Okay, go to the run mode, go to online. Now if you press this input number 5, it will turn on after 5 seconds. Okay, after, so as soon as you press this 5 button, enable bit is turned on, but DN is not turned on because the operation hasn't performed yet. So as soon as the accumulator reaches the value from 0 to 5, this done bit will turn on. 3 4, you can see here 5. So after 5 it will turn on, output is also turned on. Okay, this is for the timer on delay. Now you can go to the, you can change the preset value and you can have a look. Okay, now go for up counter. Okay, so whenever applications like conveyor belt measurement of equipments or items, you can use the counters. Okay, up counter, down counter. Now we have to look on up counter. Okay, just select, go to timer counter, select your CTU. Okay, then it will come here, then use, okay, toggle bit external. Okay, normally close, then use the input address. You can give any address from the 19 inputs. Okay, now counter name you have to give, then preset value of the counter. Okay, you can, if you want to count 10 objects and then you have to stop the operation, then you can give the preset 10 value. So as soon as the accumulator reaches from 0 to 10, the counter will turn off. Okay. Okay, the preset is 5. So as soon as the accumulator reaches the preset value, so to indicate the done bit, you have to use normally close. Okay, you can copy also here, same, just change the name. Okay, name slash DN bit. Okay, this is the enable bit, this is the DN bit. Okay, this is the output bit, output indication. Okay, output 4 is indicated. Okay, run the project comms. Then download the project. Go into run mode. So after running this, okay, when we press this switches, okay, you can see when we start to push, press this accelerometer will become 1, it will count, then 2, then 3, then 4. So as soon as you push, toggle this button for 1, accumulator will become 1 and this will glow. Okay, this is counter, up counter bit. Okay, so as soon as it is turned on, this will turn on. As soon as value reaches to a specified value, it will turn off. Okay, so now you can see here accumulator value is 1, then again I will press it, it will become 2 3 4 5. When both the values, reset and accumulator values, are equal, then bit is on. Okay, so this indicates the operation has been performed. You can see this is also on because address has given to this and output is on. So our output has been stated like if 5 items are passed through the conveyor belt, output is on or process has been completed. Okay, this is the indication of process completion. Okay, now after that you can use up counter. Again, you can also use down counter, same as that. Now we are going to have a look on latch and unlatch. Okay, specify some input, then go to bit and then choose latch and latch. Output latch, give the address. Okay, you can give same output address to both latch and unlatch. We have already seen this latch and latch process in the COP virtual lab experiment. Okay, you can refer to that. I will not give detailed information because we have already done this. Okay, then use another switch for unlatching. Okay, give the address, give unlatch, can give the same output for unlatch also. So now the operation will be like that. If you press this or toggle this switch, the motor will go into latch condition. Okay, unlatch is already on, so it will turn on, it will be green, this will also be green whenever you press this. So if again you press this, this will not turn off. To unlatch this motor, you have to turn this on. So when you turn this on, this will be green and this will be, okay, as it was green, it will turn off the unlatch which is on earlier, and after turning off of this unlatch, the motor will go into off condition. Okay, then download the program again. After every modification, you have to download the program into the PLC. Okay, run mode. Okay, now you can see as soon as it started, as soon as we press this button on the hardware, okay, this is in latch condition and latch is already running. So if you press this again, this will not turn off. To turn this motor off, you have to use this, you have to press or toggle this, then it will turn off. So as soon as I toggle, okay, this is turned off. This is how, again, as I toggle this, this will turn on both. Okay, as soon as I toggle this, this will turn off. Okay, this is what unlatch and latch is all about. Okay, so you have to save every program you do. Okay, and now we are going to have a look on the hardware right now. Good afternoon to all. So you can see here we are online. Okay,
So this symbol, when it rotates, it indicates that we are online right now and we are connected to the PLC. So we are today we are going to run different programs like AND gate, OR gate. Then we are going to have a look on the operation of on timer delay, then up counter, then down counter, and then motor latching and unlatching. So when we use different timers and counters, we are going to look at the indications, that is the done bit. So in the second rung of that counter, we are using DN bit. Okay, so the address is the name slash DN bit, name of this timer slash the DN bit. You can change the address if you want. You can use T on slash DN. Okay, so whichever bit you are going to use, enable or done, you have to give the specified address. This is the output, okay, which indicates the operation completion. Also for counter up, up counter it is same. Okay, you have to give the address as like I have given here. This is your input to the counter, okay, and this is the DN bit, okay, done bit. It will check the performance of the counter. If the counter performance is done, it will turn on, it will turn into green. Then so in case of AND gate, it's a multiplicative property. So if both are same, it will be 1. Okay, if both the bits are 1, output bit will be 1. If any one is 1 from these two, the output is 0, and for both the 0, output is also 0. So you have to, okay, I will show you the practical setup for this. So here you can see these are the digital inputs starting from I0 and ending up to I19. Okay, so we have 19 inputs or 20 inputs, and you can see here this switch is given to the, okay, it is towards the I side, which will indicate the internal connection. So if you are using any other triggering devices or toggle bits, you have to install here and you have to press this to E. For now our case is we are going to connect it to the internal, show, okay, internal shortings. So you have to connect to the I section. Okay, so now we have assigned different addresses to the PLC diagram, and these are the outputs from O0 to O11. So according to the output we have specified, it will turn on. So now for the first one, you can see it here. When I toggle these two buttons, okay, so when I press these two, I can see a green light over the PLC diagram, and the output, this output, okay, O1 will turn on. Okay, I'll show it to you. So Rahul is going to press the buttons I1 and I2, and you can see it here. Wait, Rahul. Okay, Rahul, press I1. Okay, you can see as he pressed I1, this I0, this one, okay, you can see green light over here. Now press I2. So I2 is a push button, so it will remain on only for the time when we press it. So long press it. So you can see here both the bits are on and the output is also on, okay, for turning off on the both bits. Okay, so if 1 and 2 is 1, okay, so multiplication is 1, output is 1. This is AND gate operation. Now you can see here only first bit is on and second bit is off, so output is 0. This is what AND operation is all about. Now we are going to have a look on the OR operation, which is the addition of two sequences. So in for that purpose we are connected this in parallel. Okay, so we have given address to this first bit, first contact, the address is 3 and 4, and the output is 2. Okay, So our operation is that in which if both the inputs are 1, output is also 1. If both the input are 0, output is 0. If any one of the input is 1, output will be 1. So now Rahul will press the I3 and I4 switch, and we can see light glowing over here. Now Rahul press I3. So as soon as he press I3, this is turned on. Now press I4. So after pressing I4, this bit is turned on, this bit has been toggled, and we can see output is also toggled. So if both the inputs X and Y is 1, output is also 1. Now close any one bit. So he closed the third bit, this one, but this is on, output is also on. Now close both the bits. After closing of both the bits to 0, output is also 0. This is the OR operation. Now we are going to have a look on this timer on delay. So preset value has given 5 seconds. So after 5 seconds, this bit will turn on. Okay, after 5 seconds, our motor or our switch will turn on, and this is the done bit indication. So I have given the name of the timer and slash the DN, that is done bit. So after 5 seconds, this done bit will turn on. So now Rahul will turn on this I5. This I5 has been given address as 5th input, so he will turn on. You can see here, this is turn on, and you can see accumulator calculates the value. When it becomes 5, output is turned on and done bit is also turned on. Okay, so now when we will toggle this bit to 0, put it on. After turning it off, immediately the timer will turn off. Now put it on. Turning it on, accumulator calculates the value. When the both value will be same, then bit is on. Okay, this is the timer on delay. Now we are going to have a look on the up counter. So so we have given this input bit address, that is 0/10. Okay, so that is a push button, so it will turn on until we push it. And we have given using we have used this counter up timer or counter up sequencer. So preset value is given 10, accumulator is right now 0. So as soon as we click this push button or we turn it on, this accumulator will start increasing from 0 to 10. As soon as it becomes 10, that is equal to the preset value, this done bit will turn on and it will light up green, and output will also turn on. So Rahul, now you can press the switch I10. So it is, he is turning it on. So it is counting as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So as soon as it becomes 10, you can see a done bit is on, because the operation of the counter has been succeeded or completed. After, you can see here, this is also in green, turned on. Okay, output will be off. So output will be on until only the preset value is less than accumulator value. So after that up counter, we are going to have a look on down counter down. So preset value, it will calculate or measure your values from 0 to minus, okay, or in decreasing order or descending order. So now preset value is -5, current value is 0. So as soon as we toggle this switch I9, address has given as 0/9. As soon as we toggle this to 1, this will become -1, -2, -3, -4, -5. After -5, this done bit will be on. Okay, so you can press Rahul I9. Rahul is pressing I9. So it is 1 right now, 2, -2, -3. So you can see here, one second. You can see here, this CD is also on because this is enable bit, and you can press it again. Okay, so after -5 counting, this done bit is turned off because the operation is performed. Okay, after the performing of operation, there is no need to turn this on. So that's why the PLC turned this off. Now we are going to have a look on the latching and unlatching. So for latching, as we have already seen in the virtual lab, we have to use lamp load or motor for that. And latching is a process in which first of all we will turn on the motor, so it will go in the latch mode, and again if we turn off, we toggle this bit to zero, this will not turn off until it is latched. So we have to press this unlatch switch, which is on 12. After that, unlatch will turn on and the motor will off. So Rahul now will press, one second, this I12 for latching, I2. So now you can see here I have given the address, one second, to this as 2, second input, and this is the 12th toggle bit. Okay, so now Rahul will press the second input. Okay, so as soon as he pressed it, first of all 12 he kar press kar the off hote. Okay, now motor is on relaxed condition, so when Rahul will turn this second bit on, okay, so you can see here the second bit, okay, lighted, and right now latching is done off. Okay, latching is starting of the motor. Motor is in on condition. So as soon as he will press the button again, I2, press it Rahul, the motor will not turn off although it is toggled. So now we have to press this I12 to turn the motor off. Okay, now Rahul press I12. So as he press I12, okay, motor become unlatched and it will turn off. So this is what we have performed in the virtual lab, and now we have seen the output. Okay, so this is for it, and you have, if you are able to perform this RS logic, if you have any PC you can perform, otherwise virtual lab is the best right now. So this is how the hardware of the PC or PLC looks like, okay, or works. So now we are going to have a look on the output, okay, how it is done. Okay, before the hardware, we have gone to the online simulation of PLC on that ladder diagram. Now we are going to press these switches and we are going to see the output. Okay, so for the AND gate, this I1 and I2 should be pressed and the output will be over here. Okay, so now Rahul will press that and I will show you. So first of all it is 0 0. Okay, so right now both are 0, so turn it on, turn both the switches on, and okay, so you can see here first this I1 switch is right now on, and this is push button I2, this is for the second X and Y. So as soon as he switches this on, the output glows. Okay, Rahul now switch it. So right now first bit is 1, second bit is 0, output is 0. Now press both the bits. Okay, so you can see the output here glows O1. Okay, this is the AND operation. Okay, now we are going to have a look on OR operation. Now I have assigned the third bit and fourth switch, okay, for inputs of OR gate, and this one O2 will turn on. O2 will turn on. So Rahul will press I3. Okay, so OR operation is that in which if any one of the input is on or high, the output will also high. So I3 is high right now, I4 is 0, so output will be also 1. So when he will press both I3 and I4, output will remain on. Okay, you can see here this is the output O2, it will remain on. So when he will press both the toggle switch off condition, I3 off, I4 off, you can see this output O2 will turn off. So now for up timer, I have given address of this I5. Okay, so when it will turn on, it will take 5 seconds for the timer to turn it on, and this I3 will output will turn on. So Rahul will now press the button switch. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So after 5 seconds, you can see here the output has been turned on. So timer is on right now. So now we are going to look on up counter. Okay, so I have given address of this push button I10 to the input bit of up counter. So as soon as the preset value is 5, as soon as we push it for 5 times, the accumulator value will be 5, and this I4 output 4 will turn on. Okay, so now Rahul will press it for 5 times. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So you can see here this has been turned on. Okay, so done bit is on of that counter, and after the operation it will only remain turned on. Okay, so as soon as we change the preset, it will turn off. So after that up counter, we are going to have a look on the down counter. Okay, so input for the down counter has given address of I9, and the output address is given as 06. Okay, 6th output. So right now it's turned on because it is a down counter. So before starting, it is turned on by default. After we press the I9 5 times, the preset value is -5. As soon as we press it for the 5 times, this will turn off. Okay, so now Rahul will show you. So we will pressing. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and again 1. Okay, so he has pressed that for 5 times. So from 0 to -5. After -5, you can see here this is turned off. Okay, this is what down counter is. Now we are going to have the last topic from this experiment, that is latching and unlatching of motor. So for latching purpose, I have assigned the address of this I2 push button, and for unlatching I have assigned the address of this P12, this push button. Okay, and both are internally connected, and output is will be assigned to O5. So as soon as the motor will go to the latching condition, this will turn on, this output 5 will turn on, and when we unlatch it by calling this I12, this will turn off. Okay, so now Rahul will show you. So he turned on that I2, so motor is right now in latching condition. Okay, so O5 is on, you can see here this LED O5 is on. Now again, if he presses the I2, okay, there is nothing over here, the motor will not stop. So for stopping the motor, we have to unlatch it by pressing the I12. So now we will press I12 push button, and you can see this has been turned off. This is what the unlatching and latching is. Okay, so hope you have understood all the experiments. So if possible, you can come here and you can perform. So till then, take care.